Which of the following best sums up the overall purpose behind the examples of Casper and Gauzier? Let's understand the argument author has made about Casper and Gauzier. He says, though they are exceptions in that they offer fewer products, they will eventually have to offer a vast variety as they try to satisfy their venture capitalists. So this is the overall argument made about these two startups. Here, so there are exceptions to the two are dominant trend in consumer market. That is correct, but only partially correct. So you cannot really say that this is the summary of the point made by author. It does not cover the second aspect that they will eventually have to join the rat race. Second, they are increasing the purchasing power of poor Americans. According to the author, they are also part of the systemic crisis in which companies focus only on the consumer with disposable income and does not have much to offer for America's lower classes. So even these two companies are part of that rotten system in a sense. So they are not increasing the purchasing power. It is contrary to what the passage says. They might transform into what they were exceptions to. Well, that pretty much sums up our understanding here. They are facilitating a uniform distribution. The same as option two. Contrary to what the author says, they are part of the crisis. They are not facilitating a uniform distribution.